are, Tony. Finally face to face in the MMI studios.
I know. It's scary, isn't it, really? Well, scary for me.
It's a little surreal, actually, having you here. It's been, what, we were saying, nearly a year?
Yeah, we were saying last night. It was last November, wasn't it, that you picked me up in that
one fateful
in that
evening.
Absolutely. I remember it well.
You know, we were getting loads and loads of requests, which is why we're doing this interview while you're here, from right. independent artists. Do an interview with Tony. We want to know more about Tony. What don't they know about you?
Well, they certainly don't know my age, so we're not going to talk about that, are we,
no.
at all today.
No.
You look so much younger than your brother, got to say.
That's another $10 to see it. Like, 20, actually.
Now, we've been finding out more, a lot more about Tony since he's been here, haven't we, Sid?
Indeed, yeah. One question I want to ask you, Tony. Obviously, your brother to possibly one of the most famous people in the world. Most of the
Piers
time...
Piers Morgan. Oh, sorry, I'm in Simon.
Most of the time, obviously, I'm sure you're very proud of that, but do you sometimes find that a bit of a hindrance or a very positive thing?
That's a good question, Sid, actually. It's a double-edged sword, to be honest with you. And, I mean, for example, it's very easy for me to say that, yes, the Cowell name opens doors and it's helped me enormously in what I do.
At the end of the day, okay, your brother's very famous and he's very good at what he does, but you're actually a journalist and you're an author as well, so, you know.
Well, that's right, and that's what I've done all my life. I started as an author, so I was kind of in the media, if you like, while Simon was slogging away being literally what he started off doing, delivering the post to the EMI Records, and then developing his pure A&R work. Of course, that doesn't really happen anymore because it's all about television and all about the whole entertainment world.
I was on CowellMedia.com, which is your site that has your books and your radio
yes.
work and your TV work and stuff like that, and for me, I know a lot of the indie artists are thinking, okay, Simon Cowell, American Idol, X Factor, Britain's Got Talent, and all of those amazing hit shows.
Sure.
Tony Cowell and Fame Games, what's the fit? And then I found this quote in one of the press pages on CowellMedia.com. Simon said about you, Tony always had cool records. Neil Young, The Stones, Elton John. His love of music had a big influence on me, and I had a broader musical education than most kids. To me, that spells it out.
Well, that's true. I mean, you know, and because I am 9 years older than Simon, so what I was listening to in my bedroom, which, yes, did start with a sort of Dylan, time and time again I played those albums until he was, he took them out of my bedroom and scratched them, and I never saw them again. But the truth of that is, my musical education as well, because upstairs he would listen to me playing Dylan and later on the Rod Stewarts, the Elton Johns, the Eagles and people like that, Fleetwood Mac. Downstairs, Mum, Dad were playing Frank Sinatra, who Simon absolutely adores, and even if you go to his place in LA, probably that's one of the things that he would play. But later on, what he got turned on by music-wise, probably with people like Fleetwood Mac, the Eagles in particular, he always talks about hearing in my bedroom. So that was his education. And yeah, he then made this decision of either he was going to go in the film business or go into music. So I think I helped him on the road to making the right decision.
You've worked in film as well, I was reading in your bio.
Well, we both started because we lived in Elstree, which is like, for Americans, it was like the mini Hollywood in Britain in that time, in the late 60s. And so I worked as a runner, first of all, down at, I think it was called ABPC Films down there, and I worked on the James Bond films, of course. Some of them were filmed in Pinewood up the road. And then a few years later, Simon did exactly the same thing, and he worked on a couple of movies there, and he also worked on the Shining.
So he was appropriate.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think...
Here's Johnny.
I think he used to sort of polish Jack's axe. So the story goes. But he got very, very quickly disillusioned by the whole, you know, running around on a film set. It's not great fun. You know, you've got to be really dedicated to that kind of job. So he then, Dad got him, helped him get a job in the post room at EMI, and the rest is history.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, funny you should say that, because obviously you both had an interest in media, you know, be it music, films, or indeed even being an author as such. Was that sort of inspired from your parents?
Well, yeah, it mainly comes from Mum, and she was... a dancer primarily, and then an actress as well. So we get, I think, that gene from her. Of course, you know, Mum's 85 now, as I've said before, and but she's like reliving her love of the whole entertainment world, particularly, you know, as soon as Simon's celebrity started to shine. She's got a new whole new world starting all over. So, and you can't stop her going to American Idol final, the X Factor final. She's the first one in her seat.
Wonderful.
And the last to go.
What about you? Are you the first one to want to get tickets to X Factor, American Idol?
Well, as I do actually love it. And now, fortunately, you know, it's sort of become part of my work life as well. And particularly, it started really with Idol, of reporting for various TV stations down there, and also for the other radio stuff I do. So it's all become part of my life, oddly, and I'm quite happy to embrace that.
And a journalist, you know, just reports the facts, but on a personal level, you know, judging by, you know, the music you listen to in your room as a kid, stuff that influenced Simon, and then you know what the critics say about shows like Idol and X Factor. They say, oh, you know, it's just, you know, karaoke performances and blah, 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 blah. And what about bands like the Eagles? How are you going to discover them on a show like that? I mean, do you ever look at the music and say to yourself, oh, just crave a little bit of Fame Games?
Well, I, you know, I've not been shy of saying that before on the Cow Factor or anything else. You know, I do come from that different, I like different music from Simon. And in the family, we call him Mr. Pop. We called him Mr. Pop for you know, since the Westlife days and before that. So, yeah, I come from a different corner, really, musically. I do like a bit of rock. Simon hates rock. And he still is doing what he knows best in dealing with pop. And if we can laugh at some of the bands, we can say, well, we don't like Westlife, or we don't like Paul Potts, or whatever it is. The thing is, what we have to acknowledge is that somehow this guy manages to tap into the mainstream of what the public wants. And again, I mean that in television as well, because the thing is, you know, we've had to sort of learn now that when Britain's Got Talent goes off air, I'm just talking about the UK now, or the X Factor goes off the air, there actually isn't a great deal to watch.
No.
Absolutely. You know,
and people miss it. People miss it, and that's a sign,
yeah,
isn't it?
And we sat, the last time we were in LA together for the end of Idol, and I said, you know, so when does the X Factor start? You know, because we're looking for when's the next show.
Do you know, Tony, you're saying that, I totally agree with that, but then you've got American Idol, you've got the X Factor, you've got Britain's Got Talent, you've got America's Got Talent. Is there a shelf life for programmes like this?
Well, I think there is a shelf life, and Simon would be the first to admit that, that now we're coming almost to the, let's be honest, well, as far as what he wants to do. He's, I think the X Factor, well, I've said it on air on the Cow Factor, haven't I, that this season will be his last on camera anyway, on the X Factor. The American Idol thing is slightly more complicated because of his deal with Fox, and I think there may be a couple of seasons still to go with him on there.
Mm.
I have to say the obvious thing, along with everybody else on the internet, that if Simon does finish, when he does finish American Idol, it'd be a difficult act to follow.
Who's sure.
And then it's true to say probably American Idol's then reached the end of its tenure.
Is what you say, Simon doing a couple more seasons of Idol, based on the breaking news that they've just offered him approximately $122 million as opposed to the measly $36 million he got last year?
Well, actually, that's because I haven't been on the internet the last 24 hours, that you're actually now giving me news. And I like giving new news.
Twitter.
That's actually but look, what I did know, or from personal conversations, is that I don't think there was any way that he could finish Idol this year or next year, just because of the contractual things of what he wants to do with Fox long term. In other words, finding a home for his other TV idea formats, of which there's quite a few, I'll come into in a minute, that he wants to, it's a natural home for those in America, is going to be Fox, because of his history with the channel,
sure,
with the network. So it doesn't surprise me that he's going to re-sign for a little bit more money.
I wonder if he will.
Needs it.
I think it'd be cooler if he'd say, oh, tut tut. But I want to get back to you, because this is an area that people don't cover. Everyone covers Simon. I want to talk about you. Who is Emma Lloyd?
Who is Emma? We're not allowed to say that, are we? We are. Well, Emma Lloyd's my fiancée.
She's lovely, by the way.
And she is lovely. And we've been together 5 years. And Emma, well, she used to work as a presenter on BBC Radio, which is where we met. And I was plugging one of my strange books, and she interviewed me on radio, and we probably got together almost on air.
A
bit like you and I, Sid, really.
Well, I guess so.
Yeah, similar. Thank God this isn't TV.
Is that allowed?